Dawson from creativeguitarstudio.com. If you're a beginner guitar player who's over the age of 40 and you've never understood what this idea is for guitar that you'll hear about called the CAGED method, then this video is going to be incredibly helpful to you. See, the CAGED guitar method, or sometimes it's called the CAGED guitar theory, is a pattern system that focuses on the five open position chords of C, A, G, E, and D. Now, these five chords each have unique fingering patterns already existing within all of them that are based off of their root notes. And those root notes each relate to unique shapes for what we call octave patterns on the guitar fingerboard. Now, octave patterns can be very helpful when it comes down to understanding more about chords, scales, and arpeggios, and licks, and riffs, pretty much everything we play. So grab your guitar along with a piece of fingerboard worksheet paper, and if you don't have any paper like this, stay tuned, because in a couple of minutes I'm going to get you acquainted with a current promotion that we have for a handouts collection ebook that you're going to love. You can get your hands on that. It's got this paper and tons of other charts and paper and other kinds of exercises too. But we're going to get to that in a couple of minutes. First, I want you to start working with me here as we get into learning all about the CAGED guitar method right now. In getting started, we're going to begin with the first chord of our CAGED layout, which is C major. Now, you could also do these with minor chords, but for just simplicity's sake, I'm going to do everything in this lesson plan with major. So if you don't know a C major chord, it's a pretty straightforward shape that's built off fifth string. We've got fifth string, third fret, fourth string, second fret, open third string, and then we have a C up here on the second string, first fret, and as well you can add in a first guitar string open if you'd like as well. Now, what's really important about doing this is to focus in on the C notes in particular. So we want to be well aware that there's a C note right there on the fifth string, third fret, and another C note up here on the second string, first fret. And that's our octave layout. Now, once you understand that, you can grab a sheet of guitar fingerboard worksheet paper, just like this, and go to work with it and jot down how that pattern would move along the neck. You can do something simple like begin with just natural notes. So you could have C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. Just take it all the way along the neck, keep it on all the natural notes. You can also go chromatic as well. If you'd like, you could go C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E, F, G, F sharp, G, G sharp, A. Travel all the way up. Then when you get to the top of the neck, you could descend going with flats. So you could go C, B, B flat, A flat, G, G flat, F, E, E flat, D, just like so, all the way down. And that's a really great way to get to know your neck very well, and you'll get to know how the pattern sits in different locations, and it'll really help you with your fingerboard knowledge. So jotting this stuff down on worksheet paper and doing some basic exercises like this will start getting these together. Now, that was just the first chord, C. Let's move next to the second chord, which is A. Now, I'm just gonna do the very simple bar chord version of an A major, which is gonna use the open fifth string, and then I'm gonna lay my first finger flat across the fourth, third, and second strings, giving us this A major chord right there off that second fret bar. Now, the chord is, of course, one thing, but we wanna also spend some time focusing on the individual A notes. So we have open fifth string A, and then we have another A here on the second fret of the third string. So our A octave is set up between those two notes that are spaced a whole step apart like that. And again, you could do some work on some paper first, mapping it out, or you could begin moving from A up to B, do the same spread for the octave. You know, there's a B, there's a C up from there, and then a D and an E. You could do all the natural notes at first. Here's G and A again. You could also go chromatically. You could ascend with the sharps, you know, going A, A sharp, B, C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E, F, you know, and so on. You could descend with flats, just like I talked about before. But once you learn the idea of the octave shape that's found within the chord of that CAGED system, begin moving it laterally along the strings, calling out the new notes that are associated to each new playing position. Well, now that you know the first steps for how CAG'D works, what we're going to do next is run through the remaining three patterns. Then, and this part is really important, we're going to organize what they look like on the guitar to format the complete CAG'D layout across the entire neck. But first, here's a short promotional message about an exclusive YouTube offer for my Handouts Collection ebook. I just want to take a moment to let you know about our Handout Collection ebook. I'd love for you to get a copy of this. There is a ton of great information in here. And if you already are one of the hundreds and hundreds of players who've received your copy, you already know how great this collection is. The ebook Handouts Collection is jam-packed full of different blank diagrams so you can notate anything you're working on scrap paper and start getting a better idea of how it operates. There's great scale exercises in here so you can understand the layouts of building melody a lot better, interesting stuff for diminished scale, ideas on modes. We have work on harmonized key centers, and there's ideas that go through the different kinds of diatonic chords that we have in keys. Plus, there's a fantastic arpeggio exercise in here. Plus, on top of that, we've got key signature theory and ideas for bar chords in here. There's just unbelievable amount of information in this thing. The Handout Collection ebook is available with any donation over $5 or if you make a purchase from my Creative Guitar Studio Teespring store. Visit creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to help support the guitar project, or you could check out all of our Teespring products in the console underneath this video. Moving right along, our next chord is going to be the G major. And if you're not familiar with G major, there's a couple different ways you can do fingerings. You could have it with the middle and index and ring, or ring, middle, and the small finger up on top. It's up to you. Commonly, we would use this fingering here, so I'd maybe suggest sticking with that. Using the note layout, it's just a couple of tones down under on the sixth string and fifth string. We have a G and a B down there, third and second frets. The inside strings are all open, and then you just have a high fourth finger up there on the third fret of first string G. What's important, though, of course, is learning the locations of the G notes. So we have a G on the sixth string at that third fret. We also have a G open third guitar string, and we have a G up top on the third fret of the first string. Now, that octave layout, we want to get to know that and become familiar with that, and then begin move it across the fingerboard. Now, again, it helps a lot to have fingerboard worksheet paper to draw it all out first in different positions. At least if you did about three positions along the net, you'd get a pretty good idea on the setup and how they move around. But the exercise work I had detailed before is really nice to do. Remember, we had done movements along the fingerboard of natural notes at first, and that's a nice way to begin getting the locations together. So that's excellent work, you know, just going along the fingerboard, getting your natural tones, call them out as you go, you know, like B, C, D, and so on. And you can do all the sharps and flats in between like we had discussed as well. Now, let's move on to our second last idea, which is the E, so E chord. E major chord, again, it's like G, it's all six guitar strings. So we have an open sixth string. We have second and third finger playing these 2 second fret notes on fifth and fourth string. And then we have an index finger grabbing right here on a G sharp note, first fret, third string, and then the top two strings are open. So that's our E major, and we're using open sixth string, and then second fret of fourth string, and then open first string as well. Now, that octave shape for those E notes, we can start practicing the moving along the fingerboard of those as well. Again, if you took some fingerboard worksheet paper, draw them out into some different locations, you know, get a familiar idea in your mind what the geometry of that shape looks like. And then after that, you can get to the guitar for an exercise of calling them out, like right there on first fret F, that's a F layout, and then G, A, B, C, so on and so on. Go all the way along your neck, do some work chromatically too, pick a spot even if you'd like, and come here maybe from this A and go A, A sharp, B, B sharp or C natural, C sharp, D. Go along your fingerboard, do the sharps, do some flat work and all that. Once learned, you know, the idea is to slide that octave pattern laterally, calling out the new notes that are associated to each new playing position. All right, let's get to our last chord now. It's D major. Now, D major typically is the top four guitar strings starting at the open fourth D note. And then we've got A and D and F sharp on top. and that's taken care of the notes for the D major. You can see it's kind of like a triangle shape with your index ring and middle fingers playing it in that second fret area. And we get open fourth guitar string to the second string third fret as our octave layout. So we have those two notes for the octave. If we went along the neck and did some work with natural tones, maybe we could jump next over to group E's there off of the second position, going from second fret to fifth fret. F, G, A, B, C, D, just traveling along the neck laterally like that and understanding how that setup operates. It's very important to do that work because you get extremely familiar with how the octave pattern is set up on the guitar fingerboard. And you can do that in any way that you'd like. I mean, you could put your pick down and just use your fingers and pluck those notes if you wanted to. You could use a pick and just play each note, you know, one at a time, you know, however you'd like to set it up. It doesn't really matter the execution that you use to play them, but, you know, however you perform them, that's great. But what we really want to memorize is the fretboard geometry of what it looks like on the neck. So once you have all that together, the final stage of learning is to take those notes individually and really start mapping them one to the next position on their own using the same note. Let me give you a good idea of how this works. Now, the final idea that I have for you is just based around taking an individual tone and then mapping that tone along the entire span of the guitar fingerboard. Now, this is best done starting with a sheet of blank fingerboard paper and drawing it all out on pencil first. And right now you're going to see come up on the screen a series of the C notes plotted out along the neck. And what we're looking at there is individual octave layouts. And you can see we're starting here with a C in first position. There's another C octave that you can build also off the fifth string that goes from the fifth string to third string in the third position. And then we can move up into fifth position, grab these low sixth string C notes, reaching over and across like that. And then finally, we can go from the C note located at the eighth fret to the 10th fret on the fourth string, and then a C up top. If you want to go one further yet, you could also take it as far as a C off of the 10th fret of fourth string all the way up to a C at the 13th fret on the second string. So that would be, you know, like a full exercise all the way across the neck, plotting out all your C notes. And that really would be, you know, like the ultimate exercise to do to really get to understand the fingerboard map as we would have it with, you know, all of your octave patterns joined together, utilized off of just one single tonal name. And then you could do that for, you know, A, you could do that for G, you could do that for E, you could do that for D. And I'll have all that stuff on the blogger page for this lesson. So you can go and look at all those diagrams, try them yourself, and put some good work into this. So all this comes together for you and you become very familiar with this C.A.G.E.D method on the neck. Guys, if you want to get a more detailed breakdown of all this information, including all the diagrams for each idea that I went over, then head down to my blogger page. It's free over at creativeguitarstudio.blogspot.com. And if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and thumbs up below. Also, remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you'll want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube, so go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.